Now here's Matt.
All right, Meredith, thank you. We're joined now by Democratic Senator Richard Durbin of Illinois and Texas Republican Senator John Cornyn. Gentlemen, good to see both of you. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning.
Senator Cornyn, let me start with you. Why don't we get the predictions right out of the way? How big a night do you think the Republican Party is going to have tomorrow?
Well, we're going to come back in a significant way. In 12 of the 16 states where we have competitive Senate races, they were carried actually by President Obama in 2008, which says a lot about how far we've come in just 2 years. So I think we don't get the majority back, but we've come awfully close, and we finished the job in 2012.
All right. So, Senator Durbin, I'll ask you the same question, and you can get into the predicting game. What do you think it looks like? What's the landscape look like on Wednesday morning?
I think the Democrats retain the majority in the United States Senate, and Harry Reid will be our majority leader. We understand they're close contests, but I will tell you about the polls, Matt. These polls are based on modeling. Modeling is based on predicted outcome, and we've spent the last several months making sure the outcome's different than the polls suggest.
Let me stick with you for a second. I know you've been working hard for Harry Reid out in Nevada, and I know you hate hypotheticals, but if Harry Reid does not retain his seat, his power position is up for grabs, and your name has been mentioned as a possible replacement. Are you interested?
Harry Reid's going to be the next majority leader, and I'm not going to speculate. I'm doing my best to make sure he's reelected and we retain our majority.
All right, Senator Cornyn, let me go back to you and let's get out to Alaska for a second. Joe Miller, there have been reports, and you've commented on this, but I want to ask you again, reports that some prominent Republican leaders have already basically abandoned Joe Miller and are now rooting for Lisa Murkowski in that write-in bid. Can Joe Miller win, and is there any truth to those reports?
Well, there's Joe Miller can win, and I think he is likely to win, although that race has become much more competitive. Of course, what makes it so unusual is the write-in candidacy of Senator Murkowski. But as a national party committee, the Republican Senatorial Committee has supported Mr. Miller. We continue to support Mr. Miller, and we hope to retain that seat in this election.
Senator Durbin, I just want to touch with you on a question that Chuck Todd just talked about in his report. And most people assume that Democrats are going to lose a lot of seats tomorrow night. When you look at it, where will the blame go? Is it a problem with Nancy Pelosi? Is it a problem with President Obama? What do you think the message is that voters will be sending if they oust a lot of Democrats on Election Day?
The voters want change. They don't like the high unemployment numbers, and they don't like the uncertainty of our economy. What the Republicans suggest is go back to the Bush economic policies, tax breaks for wealthy people. That didn't work. It created the unemployment we have today. So I think that's our message as we go into the closing minutes of this campaign. The folks, if they really want change, let's stick with moving America forward, not taking America back, which is the Tea Party slogan.
Senator Cornyn, in an interview with the National Journal last week, Republican Minority Leader Senator McConnell was asked what his priority would be for the Republicans after the midterm elections. Senator McConnell's answer was interesting. He said, quote, "The single most important thing we want to achieve is for President Obama to be a one-term president." It's striking to me what he didn't say. He didn't say create jobs, fix the economy, deal with national security. He said oust President Obama. Is that what you think voters want?
Well, it reminds me of what the president himself said. He said Republicans can come along for the ride, but they have to sit in the back of the bus. I agree with you, Matt, that what people want is do something about this high rate of joblessness, and they want to do something about runaway spending and debt. Those are the three issues that have consolidated people across the country, independents, disaffected Democrats and Republicans.
So are you saying you disagree with Senator McConnell? The priority should still be the economy and jobs?
I think the economy and jobs and spending and debt are the issues.
All right. Senator Durbin, Senator Cornyn, thank you guys, both of you. I know you're busy. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
NBC's Brian Williams will